tell you a story before introducing our very special musical performer, Holly Connor. I want to tell you a story about how she came to my attention, how I first heard about her, which is through one of our students, a journalism student, who wrote a story about her. Our student's Chloe Sapp. So Chloe was a freshman last year working for our student newspaper, not really accepting her role as a freshman. She was out looking for stories on her own and giving herself assignments. She met Holly on campus, saw a very special story there, waiting to be told. And so let me quote the opening sentences of the feature story that she wrote for our student paper. At 6 months old, Holly Connor started playing the piano using her toes. At age three, her vibrato hit when Stay, I Missed You by Lisa Loeb played during a car ride. 1 year later, she began piano lessons. At age seven, acting lessons. At age 10, her first musical. Connor has perfect pitch, can play a song after hearing it just once, and can make a room shake with the power of her vibrato. Connor's diagnosed with septo-optic dysplasia, which causes visual impairment, and hypopituitarism and autism. Now, obviously, these parts of Connor's life present challenges and gifts too. She's a musical savant. She can recognize, remember, and perform music that any of the rest of us would have to study and practice for weeks. Chloe Sapp, our journalism student, still in her first year of college, recognized the value of this story, wrote a beautiful, compelling feature for our student newspaper, The Journal, and then pitched the story to the Webster Kirkwood Times, where she was doing an internship. You're also, by the way, not supposed to know enough as a freshman to do an internship yet, but Chloe didn't let that stop her. They greenlit the story. She wrote another version of it for their paper. A few weeks later, one of our alumna, Erica Josephson, the executive producer of NBC News Daily, was in town to speak at our commencement ceremony. I made arrangements for her to meet some of our journalism students, and as journalists do, she began to interview them. What kind of stories do you like to write? What's a story you've written that you're proud of? Chloe said she liked to write feature stories and illustrated why it was important, feature rather than art news. She illustrated why that was important by talking about Holly Connor. Josephson was interested, got Chloe's contact info, got a clip of the story, and when she returned to New York, pitched the story to her NBC team. Just a week later, a network crew was here in St. Louis, producing a piece on Holly Connor for NBC News Daily. That's the kind of student we have here at Webster. Smart, hardworking, undaunted, and pursuing work they love because they're motivated by their own passions, learning, creating, and producing. And by the way, now in her first semester as a sophomore, Chloe's the managing editor of our student newspaper, something other students don't do until they're juniors or seniors. So Chloe, can you stand up for just a minute? And now we all get a chance to hear from Holly Connor ourselves. Holly's a second year performance major, pursuing a Bachelor of Music and a minor in Spanish. She's a singer, musician, and actor, living in St. Louis. Beginning at age 10, Holly has performed in over 100 musicals, plays, operas, cabarets, and musical reviews in school, youth theaters, and professional organizations. She has a passion for opera, musical theater, national anthems, I'm going to ask her later how many she knows, jazz, and classical piano. Holly dreams to be an invited singer with symphonies, be a voice actor and music educator for individuals with disabilities. She's also a composer and storyteller, and she recently designed the first ever pair of Braille socks for a company called John's Crazy Socks. Being born visually impaired and autistic, Holly's hope is that by sharing her story, she will continue to create and expand awareness, acceptance, and inclusion in the arts for all. This is already true here on campus as Holly's presence and performance, her positive energy and her talent are an inspiration for everyone who works with her. Let's also recognize and thank Holly's and Chloe's parents who are here tonight and Holly's grandmother too. Thank you for all you've done. Fairies at the Bottom of Our Garden by Lisa Lehman, a song originally published in 1917. Nancy Mayo will accompany on the piano.